But every fight was significant. Every fight was for a world title. And you could feel the tension as the fighters came into the ring. And that's what, if you guys really want to do something for the sport, that's what you should be insisting on. That on particularly pay-per-view cards, no nonsense with undercards.
Excuse me.
No matching guys that nobody cares about. Do title fights. Three or four title fights a show. That's what the public wants to see. And look, if we had done the usual show here, where we had some good fighters, 10-round fighters, fighting, starting at 6 o'clock when the telecast went on, nobody would have been in the arena. But by putting on four title fights, the arena was virtually full by 6, and by 6:30 it was completely full. And that's the way it should be, and that's the way it is in a lot of places around the world. If we had done just Pacquiao and Vargas and three other fights on the card, nobody would have got here before 8 or 8:30. And that's not good for boxing. Okay, we have a future star, young man, Honduran descent, born in the greatest place in the world, Brooklyn, New York, where I was born, and lives now in Miami. He had a great performance tonight. Please welcome, he's only 19, we're going to hear from him. He's a future world champion. Please ring. Please welcome Tito Lopez.
What's up, everybody? Everything's good, man. 19 years old, just made my professional debut in a great card. Manny Pacquiao versus Jesse Vargas. To be honest, Pacquiao really looks like he got two more fights than he did, three. What else can I say? I entertained today. I fought early. God first. I want to thank God. And I just want to thank Bob Arum, Top Rank, my manager, David McWhorter, my team management. And I'm really thankful, man. I won the 2016 U.S. Olympic Trials. Not many people know that. Two people know that. I just felt tremendous today. There's a lot more coming, to be honest. This is just the start of what's here to come. A lot of politics have happened to me. I went to the Olympics, couldn't represent USA, so I decided to represent my family's country, my parents' country, Honduras. What doesn't kill you only makes you stronger, So that's what made me stronger, and I'm thankful today that I'm here right now talking to everybody, even though many are not listening, but hey, I'm still up here. And what else? Just thank you, Bob, for everything, to be honest, and thank you for taking me here.
I got some advice for you. Your father said you're not gonna get some guy down 6 times, right? 6 times? All right, but here's my advice. You get a guy down, kick him in the head so he don't get up. You're wasting a lot of energy. What if there's, there's always something to say, but if there's one thing to say that I'm really troubled with, and it's good to say it now because there's no, you complain about the judges and you can be a sore loser, and so I'm not complaining about any decision or anything because they were all correct, but the judge in the Nonito de Magdalena fight, who gave Donaire only 2 rounds, never should be allowed to judge again. I mean, the other two judges had Magdalena winning very, very close. You could argue that that was correct, or Donaire winning close, correct. But to give Nonito Donaire only two rounds in that fight, you wonder what that particular judge was seeing. And then the Pacquiao fight, two judges had to fight like everybody else. They gave Vargas two rounds, I think one guy gave him three, but really, that's the maximum. He fought a courageous fight, he fought a good fight, but we all knew what we were watching, except for one judge who scored Manny, gave Manny the victory by 1 point, by virtue of the knockdown. He had six rounds to six rounds, gave Manny the extra point to the knockdown. Now, what fight was that judge watching? And shouldn't the commission here that prides itself on having the best judges and the best this and the best that have a seminar or something to tell these guys what to look for? I mean, and it's easy for me to say that here because I'm not saying you stole a fight from my fighter or anything like that. But my God, it really goes to the credibility of the sport when you have, in these two fights, individual judges having scored the fight so much differently from what everybody saw and what the other two judges in each fight saw.
Hey, Bob, to your right in the back. Back here. I just wanted to get your comment. I thought it was remarkable what Manny did, nearly 38 years old, having a full-time job in the Senate, to come in and win 10 out of 12 rounds and perform as he did. And I wonder if you could just comment on, you know, it wasn't the young Manny Pacquiao, but certainly he was a dominant champion, and give it all he had on his plate, how he did.
Well, I agree with you to this extent. The fact that he is a full-time senator and can only train really around his day job as a senator because he chairs committees, etc. That is absolutely remarkable for him to have been in the shape that he was to go these 12 rounds tonight. As far as his age is concerned, that's just a number. As a man who knows what he's talking about, I have a number attached to me, and I just feel it's just a number that had nothing to do with the number of years that I've been on this earth. And I think Manny feels that way. He may be 38, whatever, but he acts and has the energy of a much younger person. All right, we have the featherweight champion of the world, one of the young men that I predicted will be one of the big stars in boxing in the years to come. He is a two-time Mexican Olympic team member. He was born in Nogales, raised in Tucson. He is a symbol for all of us that you build bridges and not walls. He is the Mexican dream and the American dream, the featherweight champion of the world, Oscar Valdez.
Thanks, everyone. There's a lot of people I'm here to thank you for this. First off, God, thank God for this victory. Obviously, by grabbing top rank, and they're the ones who made me a champion, who made me defend my title and get this victory. Starting with Manny, I want to thank Manny and Edgar Castle, because no one works harder than those two guys. They take no days off. Their birthday, Christmas, New Year's, it's the same day for, same training day for us. They take no days off. And Manny, the greatest of all, I was thinking about Tony and Frankie. I see my father. My father is the one who made me this, who has who let me have this attitude, who showed me, who introduced me to boxing world. I gotta thank my father for this. And you know, I'm just happy. My first step, defend my title. I'm very happy for this. He said it last year. I said 2016 was gonna be my year. And, you know, thank God, I became a world champion. I got my first title defense. And hopefully 2017 is gonna be better. So thank you all for seeing this fight and hopefully give you better things. Thank you.
We had a league everybody who watched the telecast enjoyed the announcers. I think they did a great job. I want to thank, we had a very surprised visitor who commented from the row behind and helped the commentators. Floyd Mayweather made a surprise appearance, and he had a number of things to say, which became part of the telecast.
What do you think about Floyd being ringside, and do you have interest in Mayweather-Pacquiao too?
Floyd is retired.
He said in the article that he's open to coming back.
What? You know, jerking somebody's chain. As far as we're concerned, as far as what he's telling us, he's retired. I respect that.
Was Mr. Mayweather, did he invite himself, or did he?
No, no, he called. He was very nice. He called. He said he wanted to come to the fight. So Todd DeBuff got him credentials and a great seat right behind the commentator. And we got tickets for his entourage. So no, he was very, very nice. He didn't just show up and barge in. He called and asked if he could come.
Did that surprise you, Bob, that he called?
Don't shout out questions without the microphone because I can't hear.
What, who's got a question?
Me, did it surprise him when Mayweather called that he wanted to attend the fight? Did it surprise him when Mayweather called that he wanted to attend the fight?
I didn't even know, because when he showed up, I was surprised. And then I found out that he had talked to Todd and made arrangements to come. So no, I wasn't surprised. Because I didn't know.
Bob, have you had any thoughts on matching up Manny Pacquiao with Terrence Crawford in the future?
Well, I obviously have a lot of thoughts all the time. But Manny told me that there's a period of time, which is my first concern always, because remember, this is not his day job. His day job is being a senator. That there is a relatively long period for a recess. It says a spring recess around Easter time. And so that's my first job is to confirm everything and pick some possible dates, and then we'll go and decide on the opponents. I mean, I'm not dealing with a normal boxer situation. I'm dealing with a situation with a senator, which is a very high position in the Philippines, who wants to keep boxing. So everything revolves around the senatorial duties.
Bob over here. Hello, Bob. Hello, Bob. Hello. One of the things, I don't want to labor the point, but Mayweather has never attended a Manny Pacquiao fight, apart from the one who fought against him. Is this sign of the fight? Does that all move forward?
Well, Gareth, with all due respect, that's a question you should address to Mr. Mayweather.
But you know, the feeling is that he came because he was interested in seeing how Manny was.
Talk to him. That's the way he came. I wanted to come. I have no idea. So what am I going to get up here and answer your question and bullshit some answer? And that make you happy?
Thank you.
You're welcome. must say my Chinese partners have told me that they're so overjoyed with Zhou Shiming's victory that they're dancing in the streets of Shanghai. And we don't know, but we believe that the president of China, Xi Jinping, was watching the telecast of the fight. So that's pretty great. That's, you know, I mean, the president of China is a very high person, not only in China, but the world. And the fact that he's a boxing fan and a fan of Zhou Shiming really is great for the sport of boxing.
What do you foresee in Magdaleno's future after this fight?
You know, we always have great confidence in Jesse Magdaleno. We promoted every one of his fights, I think what's that, 24 now? And there were a period of time that we were disappointed because he seemed to be half-hearted and was sort of lazy, not making weight and that kind of thing. But under the tutelage of Frank Espinosa, who's a great manager, he seems to have turned it around. And there are a lot of fights that we could make for him at 126 and 122. I know my friend Al Heyman has some great featherweights and junior featherweights that we can match Jesse against. We have some. So you know, Jesse won't lack for action.
Bob, what was the attendance tonight?
What?
The attendance.
I don't know what the attendance was yet, but it looked to me like it was virtually a sellout. What? 16, 122. One third, hey, that was it. Extra 10 people, you know? That's Christmas money. 16, 132. But it was great. Let me tell you something. This is addressed to Las Vegas people, Nevada people. This was only made possible because the athletic director at UNLV and the coach agreed to change the date of an exhibition game, which was scheduled tonight in the Thomas and Mack, and to move it to another date to free up the building so we could do this event. Now we have in this town three other arenas that are owned by MGM. And unfortunately, by the time the Senate decided that the only date really Manny could fight was November 5, the MGM had booked all three arenas. There's the bull riding at the T-Mobile, and there's other stuff at MGM and Mandalay Bay. So the UNLV provided us with a great service to enable this fight to take place in Las Vegas.
Bob, what do you plan for Zhou Shiming fight next year, and who will be faced next year for defending the world title?
Well, you know, that we have to sit with his people. We have to find out where he wants to fight. It's hard to wrap your hands around this because Zhou Shiming is one of the most popular sports figures in China. You know, we see a little flyweight, you know, who, you know, nice kid, but we don't understand how big he is in China. Another question is, does he fight in China? Where would he fight? Does he fight someplace else, like back here in the United States? I don't know. I have to talk to my Chinese partners in Singa and Sean Gibbons, who seems to be pulling the same neck. Sean, yeah. Trump may have Putin, but Sean Gibbons has he should be.
Bob?
Back.
Bob. Bob, if Manny Pacquiao was to continue to fight, and it were up to you, which fight do you want made?
Well, off the cuff, without really exploring all options, I would say Terrence Crawford, maybe, who has a tough fight coming up December 10th on HBO. Vasyl Lomachenko, who has a tough fight at the Cosmo here in Las Vegas on November 26th, which will also be televised by HBO. And maybe, depending on the timing, Danny Garcia or Thurman would be a possibility. So all of those guys would be in the mix. You know, moving, punching. I love when he throws a punch and he disappears around the guy and comes out on the other side. That to me is really great craftsmanship.
You will go to the Philippines in January?
All right, we got good news from Doug. There is no delayed telecast, but we're keeping the pay window open so that if people who miss this event want to see it, they can pay their cable system or their satellite providers or on the internet to view the telecast and pay the same as the people did tonight. Here we come. Manny, talk about Manny's conditioning. Hall of Fame trainer Freddie Roach.
I thought Manny had a pretty good fight tonight, and I thought Vargas showed a lot of heart. And he was a very good opponent, and they had a lot of heart, and they tried really hard, but Manny was just trying to win. Manny's getting stitched up in the back room right now. He had a cut in the last round, so he'll be here in a little while. If you have any questions, please go.
Congratulations, Freddie, on a fine performance. One of the things we were asking Bob, he won't appreciate this for me, but what did you make of Floyd Mayweather coming tonight and sitting in Manny's corner?
I didn't see him, but I think that was nice of him. He's came by my gym a couple of times over the past couple of months, and very nice, polite. I hope he's looking for Manny Pacquiao, but we'll see.
Thank you.
What do you think about Joshua Min's play today? How about his offensive? Is he pulling so much?
How many again?
What do you think about Joshua Min's play today? And how about his offensive?
It was a good win for Joshua Min. I mean, he fought a good fight. Last time I fought that guy, it was a pretty close fight. I mean, the guy's won 12 in a row since. It was a very good win, and he dominated the fight. And Shimin held my 38th world champion. It was nice to be there.
He
fought a good fight and so forth, and the opponent was a little bit, I thought it was Jesse Reyes, and he had a lot of heart. He hung in there, and he hurt him more than a couple of times, and he kept coming. He's got a lot of heart, a lot of balls. I like watching him. He's a good kid.
Freddie,
I know that you were looking for an early knockout, talking about that last few days. Were you a little disappointed that Manny didn't get the knockout?
Yeah, I was a little disappointed. Yeah, they had a nice knockout in there earlier. I thought that might go through them and
upload
so I can catch my slipping, I guess.
How did Manny feel about that? Was he looking for a knockout? And is he a little disappointed?
No, but we know that knockouts, they count on that. If they do come, that's a bonus, and he doesn't go out there looking for a knockout. He's just not, he's never does that. So, again, if a knockout does come, it leaves a bonus, and it didn't happen.
The
sensorial duties, like Aaron, for how much do you think PACQUIAO could have been better without having to deal with those and the effect of that having the training?
Well, no,
you know, we had a good training camp. I mean, it was really busy with the setup and all that, but he trained hard every day and he was happy. And going into this fight, he was really well prepared. I thought he did well. I think we're going to have to get used to this because he's going to be a senator for the next 6 years and he's not done fighting yet. Well, maybe he's going to get a decision with the doctor right now. He should be here pretty soon. It's not a large gun, it's a small gun, and he just needs a couple stitches. But, thank you.
Even though the hour draws late, the good news is that tomorrow morning early, turn the clocks back so you pick up an hour of sleep.
Good evening, thank you, Bob. Well, we came up a bit short from the looks of it. I'm not going to argue with the scorecard. I'm not going to argue with the referees here in Las Vegas. I feel that we have the best officials. I do feel that it was a good, entertaining fight. It was a chess match. It really was. I had to stay alive every second of the fight. As you saw, I believe it was the third round. I got a little confident. He caught me with this. I got a little more confident with the speed, and he caught me with a good, sharp left hand. But over the entire fight, I believe that it was a chess match. I expected, Manny to be a little more aggressive as he usually is. And we were expecting to catch him with that nice right hand. We were looking for it over and over again. We caught it a few times. We got stunned him a couple times. But he's a very experienced fighter. I give him credit. He's a legend. And I hope that everyone here enjoyed the fight. I tried my best. I tried to give you an entertaining fight. I was staying on my toes. I was trying to catch him as much as I could coming in, and I'd be aggressive from time to time, and it got a little heated as well. But overall, I hope that you enjoyed it, and I feel that it made me a better fighter without a doubt. Just being in there with Manny, and his people.
Amazing job they did for promoting this show. A lot of people from around the world were really intrigued by this fight and they tuned in, so that's a great thing. Secondly, I want to give a big congratulations to my guy, Jessie Vargas. A lot of people thought this would be like a Chris Algieri type of fight, and he showed tonight his huge heart, his huge desire to compete and be a winner, and what I call him, the lion champion he is. He fought very hard. He never gave up on himself. It was a very close fight, I felt. And I just want to give Jesse Vargas a big round of applause, man. He fought his ass off. And it's sounds odd, but I don't want him to have his head down. I don't want him to feel bad or sad. I want him to be proud of his efforts, because all you can do is the best you can do. And that's what it is. I'm hurt inside because, you know, I try my very best to motivate my fighter, and you know, I'm a little sad about the way the fight ended for us tonight. But you know, we have to take our disappointments just like we take our victories and our celebrations. We have to be strong men and accept what life deals us, and I'm gonna do that, and we're gonna come back stronger. Last thing I wanna say, I wanna congratulate Manny Pacquiao. He did it again. I didn't think he could, but he did it again, so congratulations to him, to his training staff, to all of the Philippines, and especially to Freddie Roach. And for the record, I never disrespected Freddie or said anything foul about Freddie. I love them both, and congratulations to Team Pacquiao, Team Legend also.
Is any questions from the media? Please ask Jessie now, and if not, he'll be on his way.
Hi, Julian Fortaleza from Philippine Asian News Today Canada. In the middle of the fight, it seemed like you were having more success landing the right hand. Were there any specific adjustments you made to improve your performance?
Well, we're trying to time it coming in. You know, we caught him a few times, which had him more cautious than usual. As you saw, he wasn't coming in very comfortable. And, you know, we felt we stunned him, but, you know, he was very quick on his feet. You know, when Bradley said that he was complaining about his toes, you know, you definitely got to stay on your toes with Manny, and, you know, he's quick. You know, he was in and out real quick, and I feel that was, you know, I stayed trying to connect him with the right hand. He was coming in now. It wasn't that easy to connect.
Jesse, right here in front. When you were in the ring with Manny Pacquiao, and we spoke a lot before the fight, you know, what were you thinking would be like to be in the ring with such a great fighter, a legend, all the things that Manny has done? You're very confident. When you got in the ring and you went 12 rounds with this guy, even though he won the fight, did you feel like you were out of your depth with a guy like him because of everything he'd accomplished and how he was handling you? Or did you feel like, even though you lost, you felt like, you know what, I belong here in this kind of fight and I can compete, even though maybe it didn't go your way?
Without a doubt, I belong there. You know, this is where I belong. I mean, to have Manny Pacquiao, I think, two, three, four times before coming in, I mean, he wasn't coming in comfortably. You know, I was trying to catch him every chance that I got. You know, but, you know, which made it a chess match. It made it very interesting, very intriguing. I mean, we were both thinking in there, trying to connect with different shots. You know, like I said before, Manny Pacquiao wasn't as busy because he knew that I was waiting for him to come in. I was trying to connect as much as I could to give the fans a good fight. But, you know, I hope that they enjoyed it overall.
One other question for you, Jesse. Can you describe the punching power that Manny still has? He hasn't had a knockout for a long time, but he's been scoring knockdowns. Obviously, he dropped you. Can you just compare his power to some other guys you may have been in with, and how does it compare?
He has good speed. When he caught me in the beginning of the fight, I didn't see the punch coming, which, you know, resulted in a flash knockdown. But I got back up and I made sure to time his speed down, and that's when the right hand started coming in. But then he was starting to be very cautious with my right hand, and which resulted in him not being as busy.
Jesse, did you feel frustration that you couldn't connect with the right hand, and if so, what point in the fight were you starting to get frustrated?
I wasn't frustrated. I mean, we wasn't connecting that much, well, at least I felt. You know, I have to look back at the videos, but, you know, he would do some flurries every now and then, but they weren't connecting very much. He would connect with that left from time to time, and I would connect my right from time to time, so I thought it was an even fight, to be honest. That's what I felt inside that ring. I don't argue with the judges, but I felt that it was a close fight. And that's what I was feeling. So, I mean, I belong here, and I know that I'm sorry that I let my fans down in this fight. I hope that they enjoyed it, and I plan to use it as experience, come back stronger, and capture another world title. I mean, this is only the beginning of my career. Manny Pacquiao has more world title fights than I have fights. You You know, I'm still very young, and I'm going to use that alert as a learning experience. I promise to get better from it and come back and capture another world title. I'm not going to win. I'm going to get stronger.
How quickly would you like to come back?
That's up to my manager and promoter. But for now, we'll just go back to the drawing board with my team. You know, I'm very proud of my team. You know, it was a good match. To me, it was a good match because we were both thinking in there, trying to, you know, connect with clean shots. And to do that against Manny Pacquiao, it means that I have a bright future. That's the way I see it. And my team and I, we're going to continue going back to the drawing board and push forward.